Welcome back to Let's Play The Legend of Heroes, Song of the Ocean, a Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari, here on the Grumble. And the last ship we were on was called the Stomach. I guess this is the least weird one. Gotta talk to Grandpa again. Let's talk to her. Oh, Ripthea. That was amazing how you get rid of the sailors. I didn't even have time to offer assistance. Yeah, we saved all our finishing moves, you know how it is. Of course, it was to be expected from the heroes who took down the swing gang. Hiring those roguish fellows... I don't know what Rish was thinking. Or rogue fellows. Can I walk through here? Ah, yes. I don't know why I want to save the exclamation mark people for last. The fight was quite a sight. You're more fighters than musicians. Well, you're a pretty good poet yourself. Forte says, my grandfather has this weird street performance technique. It's not street performance technique, but self-defense technique. You can deal with a few rough sailors. Alright, hold on 1 second, guys. Okay, it just sounds, like, quieter to me than I thought it was my settings. Thank you for your help earlier. It was a close call. To be honest with you, I was really scared. Thank you very much for getting rid of the sailors. I can meet my friends according to the schedule. What schedule? A razzle-dazzle party is not for me. I came here because I'm interested in the audition. Surely it sounds like the principal, says Una. Forte says, didn't you nominate someone from the school? Like Schuber, for example. He may do pretty well. He's still a greenhorn. By the way, if I bring only one student, it's not fair to the other students. Those sailors were such degenerates, they needed to be taught the very basics of compassion through your music. Well, we used our fists and stuff instead. I was ordered by those scornful sailors to carry their liquor and food. You freed me. But, when you think of it, I wonder if they really need all that food just for a party. They can't have that many guests. It's the sacrifice to the great octopus god. Alright, let's talk to the grandpa over here. We'll talk to the little girl first. Look, it's shining. Hey, those birds in the sky are white as snow. The sea is magnificent. Did you know? Seawater tastes salty. I wonder how much salt they put in. How much salt they put in. Those sailors were terrible. I wonder if they were pirates before. Yeah, they said they were ex-pirates. Well, someone said that. Una says, don't say there are pirates nearby. There were, before Rish bought Ryutom Island. We had a village on the island, too. Pirate ships were showing up quite often to ransack the village. Anyway, those rogue sailors are babies compared to pirates. Not sure why we had to talk to him for that, but... Alright, let's talk to the captain. Thanks for your help back at the pier. They've been troubling us. I appreciate your getting rid of them. McBain says, those nasty sailors are causing a lot of trouble. Una says, but it's okay now. The next time those high-handed guys come on board, we'll just have to show them this. Well, the Viscount entrusted them this with us, said the captain. Where is it? He's trying to find a letter. Letter of warning. Those who illegally take possession of the Grumble ferry will be prosecuted under the laws of the Principality of Pensola. The Principality of Pensola announced its official position against these villainous acts. You'll be safe. Their high-handedness will not go unpunished. Okay, now what? I wonder how much salt they put in. Oh. He's saying my grandfather has this technique or something? McBain says, it's not street performance technique, but self-defense technique. You can deal with a few rough sailors. Maybe Ritter said that. I'm not sure if McBain said that, though. Whichever. Is that a door? Wait. No. Okay. And I clicked it too, like we were going to use our special McBain punch to get through. That would not be good. Okay. Is there something we need to be doing? Because nothing's going on here. Oh, the captain's back there and oh, now we talk to him. Okay. Oh, by the way, we have a favor to ask of you. Nah, really? We never get asked favors. What is it? Says McBain. We gave our passengers a lot of displeasure. If possible, could you please perform for them? Of course, I'll pay you for your performance. I just want them to have fun. It's the least I can do after giving them trouble. It's a great idea, Captain. You always think of your passengers. We'll be happy to amuse your passengers with our music. Wow, says Una. We can perform again on the boat, Forte. Yeah, it's so relaxing and pleasant to be on the boat. Thank you. I think the deck at the bow makes a perfect stage for your performance, so we have a deal. The deck on the bow. The bow is the back, isn't it? Was the bow the front and the stern is the back? I know starboard is right and port is left, but after that I forgot. Okay, I guess it's here. Well, what should I perform, says Forte. How about that one, Una says. Forest and Sea Memory. Yeah, I've been curious about that one. We haven't practiced it much yet, says McBain. Or at all. Forte says, we just have to do our best. If we make a mistake, we can perform a different tune to make up for the blunder. It's a good opportunity for us to practice it for the audition. Makes sense, says McBain. Let's do it then. All right, says a sailor. Is something happening here? Forte says, yes, we're going to entertain you. That's great. I'll gather some audience for you. Thanks, says McBain. Leave it to me. Was your name Beaver? McBain says, by the way, Forte, why don't you host the show this time? You need the experience. What? Me? Speaking in front of people gives me butterflies in my stomach. Of course, it doesn't happen when I'm performing. Get a grip on yourself, says McBain. All right, I'll do it. Don't be tensed up, and don't try to make an impression. Just express yourself in your own words. Go for it, Forte, says Una. The sailor says, hey, I brought your audience. Yet we see them. Oh, thanks, says McBain. Go. Forte says, Well, hello.
Hello!
Everyone, thank you for coming. We are the McBain Company. Shom says, what's going on? Are they going to do something?
Hush, Shom. Be quiet.
The captain of the ferry has asked us to give a performance. He wants to make up for all the inconveniences today. We'll begin our performance now. I hope you like it. Forte says, well, I made some mistakes. Lopthia says, I didn't notice them at all. It was a great performance. Wow, that was great, says Donk. Mattia says, I kept sighing. Shom says, you guys are so cool. The principal says, the tune, it's my first time hearing the piece, but it sounds a little familiar. Is it a Leon? McBain says, you have good ears, Principal Forgeon. This is called Forest and Sea Memory. It's a piece that has been played on Ryutom Island. Incidentally, we're heading for the island ourselves. These people, I think they all know where they're going. The principal says, only the famous McBain Company can give such a masterful performance. That was an exquisite rendition. Thank you for adding a colorful memory to our sea voyage. It's our pleasure, says Forte. This is a new piece, and we may not have played it as well as we should. We thank you for having stayed with us until the end. This is the end of our show. Thank you very much. Clap, 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 clap. Whew, I was nervous. Did I do okay with my speech? Yes, you did, says Una. You were really good up there. McBain says, I can give you a passing mark, but only barely. After many speeches, you'll get used to it and won't feel as awkward. I have a great respect for Uncle Shao, says Forte. He is so eloquent. You shouldn't respect a guy like that. You pulled off a big job, Forte. Let's take a rest. I'm gonna go seepy.
It was a wonderful performance. It reminded me of my hot-blooded young self. We thought traditional troubadours had become a thing of the past, but obviously I was wrong.
It's an honor, says McBain.
My grandchildren also enjoyed it. Thanks for a good memory.
You only have one grandchild there with you. Unless one's invisible or something. You guys are really cool. How do you produce such a beautiful sound? Well, says Forte, practice, practice, and practice. You must be working pretty hard. I wish I could play a musical instrument or two. Oh, you're young, you can just start learning it. Get Grandpa to get you an instrument. Your performance was quite an amusement. You deserve to be professional musicians. Who says we're not professional musicians? Miss Ripthea says, Forest and Sea Memory, you said the tune was, right? Why don't you play it at the audition? They did mention they were going to do that. McBain says, it's a pretty tough piece to play, so we can't make a decision until we practice it a little more. Then please practice hard. I look forward to hearing it again. Thank you. This is your performance fee. Please take it. Forte and his friends received 200 gents. Hey, thanks, McBain says. We gratefully accept the money. By the way, I was surprised. I never expected that you would perform Forest and Sea Memory. To tell you the truth, I was born on Ryutom Island. I grew up with that tune. You did, says Forte? It reminded me of the old days. I haven't heard it for a long time since Rish took control of the island. If I may ask, says McBain, why did Ryutom Island become a private property of Rish? Well, it was around 3 years ago. Ryutom Island was attacked by the pirates almost every day. They took all our crops and seafood and emptied the island. I heard about the pirates, says Forte. But how do pirates connect to Rish? When we were suffering from the pirates' attacks, Rish offered to buy the island. We finally made the decision that it was a better option than staying there and continuing to be threatened by the pirates. We chose to sell the island to Rish and use the money to relocate to another land. Luna asks, so what happened to the pirates? Rish called the Pensola army for assistance, and the army cleared away the pirates, I heard. After all residents and pirates were gone, he built his luxury mansion on the deserted island, at the sacrifice of the lush nature of Ryutom Island. Forte says, it's a disheartening story. We can't do anything about it. It just breaks my heart every time I go back to the island. I wonder how my younger brother Roland is feeling. Your younger brother? Says Una. Yes, he is a chef. He was employed as a chef for this party. He despises Rish. Why on earth is he helping with his party? We've almost reached Ryutom Island. I must go and give instructions to the sailors. Please prepare to disembark. McBain says, we've arrived at Ryutom Island. They say Rish's mansion is gaudy and full of bad taste. But we may find a resonance stone. There seems to be a connection between Lyon and the island. It's worth checking out. Let's study the map. McBain opens the magic map. Alright. How do I move that? I can't seem to move it, actually. It won't move. Okay, never mind. Here, I found it, says Forte. A bullseye, says Una. McBain says, we'll be pretty busy. We must find a resonance stone while competing in the audition. These are our two missions on Ryutom Island. I want to check with the people downstairs one more time. While Forte and his friends were absorbed in the conversation, their minds filled with expectations, Ryutom Island drew nearer. Well, McBain said they're actually there. The captain says, reporting entry into the port. We will wait for the guests to disembark and then send the outgoing passengers to Polka. The sailor says, hey, captain, I told you to let only the guests in. Well, there's a chest there. By the way, what happened to our guys? You came at the perfect time. I wanted to give you this document. The captain handed the letter of warning to the sailor. Well, it's a letter of warning. Those who illegally take possession of the Grumble Ferry will be prosecuted under the laws of the Principality of Pensola. What the hell is this? Your friends are arrested by the soldiers of Pensola, says the captain. Now that they're gone, we must hurry our way to the next destination, Polka. Damn you, says the sailor. I must do something. Like hop and run away. That'll do it. Well, they just look at the captain and then walk away. Hey, says Sham. Are you getting off? You're too young to be asking that question.
Well, Sham and everyone, I think we must say goodbye here.
Goodbye? I won't see you again. Una says, we'll see each other again, I promise. Forte says, she's right. We're troubadours, after all. Yes. Donk says, thank you for everything. Mattia says, I look forward to hearing your wonderful performance again. Our pleasure, says Forte. We'll practice more so we can play much better the next time. Captain says, if you see my brother Roland, please say hello to him for me. Tell him to quit cooking for Rish and come back soon. We'll do that, says McBain. Unanchor the Grumble! Or the little girl and the grandpa weren't getting off? Aye aye, sir, says the sailor. They're gone, says Forte. And look, we're standing right in front of this chest. We should prepare to disembark, says McBain. We've already disembarked. We should prepare to open this chest. Orb of Ocean 81. Cool. I'm not going to view it. I just want to see what it is. A marble with the image of Rish. Okay. Is the town north or south? I thought it was south. I mean, maybe it is. What's all this? Oh. Arana says, hi there, welcome to Ryutom Island. Are you party guests? McBain says, no, we're here for the audition. Oh, for the audition. Elise, guests have arrived. You're here for the audition, right? May I have your names, please? We are the McBain Company. We've been nominated for the audition. Please wait for a while. Yes, certainly. You were nominated by Ambassador Gareno. I will process your registration. By the way, my name is Elise. I'm assisting the audition contestants. Pleased to meet you. Oh, hello, says McBain. It's so polite of you. Elise, as a token of our new friendship, allow me to play a love ballad for you. What? Huh? She says. Forte says, oh, please ignore him. He got seasick and is doing all these crazy things. What did you say? Says McBain. Well then, let me take you to your room. Please follow me. I want to look around the dock some more, though. I'll tell you a little about the island as we walk to the annex. The big building you see over there is the mansion of Rish Campbell, the host of the party. It's incredibly huge, says Forte. I don't agree with his taste, says Una. On the first floor, we have the guest lobby and the VIP room to receive ambassadors and other foreign dignitaries. McBain says, I hear that you have a casino in the basement. Oh, you already know. I wasn't sure if I should take you there because you're with small children. They're not small children. I mean, I think of them as like, they're teenagers, right? Oh, I just wanted to know if there is one. Una says, excuse me, what is a casino? Well, McBain says, sorry, Elise, it's... Forte says, oh, I know, it's a place to have fun. A place to have fun, says Una. Grandpa wants to keep it a secret. That means he wants to have fun there without us. Elise says, roughly speaking, it's a place we gamble money and play games. Really? Says Una. Grandpa Mac. Grandpa, we didn't come here to have fun. Please turn your attention over there. Well, good save, Elise. Way over there, I can't see. Well, there's a chest. And I see walls. The cliff is called Pig Nose. Forte says, Big Nose? It's Pig Nose, says Una. It looks like the nose of a pig. On the map, this island is shaped like a lying pig. That place is the nose part. That's interesting, says Forte. Forte, let's take a look later on, Una says. Okay. Chest. I hope I didn't miss anything at the docks. Now we are entering the annex. This is the annex. Okay. The contestants have rooms on the first floor. The second floor is for the party guests. Forte says, which means we'll be staying on the first floor with Xiao and Rachel. Whoopthia and Principal Forgin are on the second floor. Before I take you to your room, shall I show you the west side of the island? Yes? Sure? Okay. Item shop, I guess? This is a souvenir shop. You should be able to find something to bring back for your memory on Ryutom Island. Everything is locally made, so I'm sure they are all interesting to you. Now, please come this way. What way? We went up that way and then we're looking down here. Oh, okay. This is our beach. McBain says, it's a tropical island, but this place looks a little cold. I don't know why. Una says, that's because we have no beautiful ladies in bikinis. McBain says, don't look at me like that. I was just... Grandpa, behave like an adult. My point is that the artificial sand beach is a little dull. Are you sure? Says Forte. Look over there, says Elise. Saving the day again. Another pig part? It's pig's tail. Forte says we had the pig's nose there, and here we have the pig's tail. It's funny. Whoever named them has a good sense of humor. Una says, did Rish destroy the nature and change the island for his own enjoyment? It's true with everything else, but pig nose and pig tail are the only exceptions. After the mansion was built, Ryutom Island became completely different from what it was before. But luckily, pig nose and pig tail remain the same. Remain the same, says Forte. Yes, just as they were before. I'm not sure what Forte is not getting here. Let's move on, shall we? Ooh, look at that piano. Mensch. The stage where the contestants will perform? This is your stage. We'll have the audition here tomorrow. Well, says McBain. It's a grand amphitheater. It's romantic, says Una. Forest and Sea Memory would be a perfect piece to play here. Forest and Sea Memory? Asks Elise. Do you know the music? Forte says, we were given the musical score in Pensola. I see. Elise, says McBain, are you originally from the island by any chance? Yes, I am. I'm working on the island by a little turn of fate. If you want to practice, feel free to use this stage. All right, let me take you to your room. What's this turn of fate she's talking about? This is your room. Forte says, wow, it's really lavish. Una says, the beds are so soft. McBain says, it's too much for people like us. Una says, look, Forte, we can watch the ocean from here, too. Really? Yeah. McBain, don't spoil it. Just let him stay there. Yeah, I can see the ocean. I love a room with an ocean view, says Una. It reminds me of Reiko's Palma. McBain says, that rocky shore would be a perfect place for fishing. We should be able to catch a lot of fish there. I just remembered, said Elise. Leon left something on that rocky shore. Leon left something? Says McBain. Yes, Leon's emblem is engraved on one of the rocks. I think Leon himself engraved it when he visited this island. That's great, says Una. Fantastic, Forte says. McBain says, we just arrived and we already know where to look. How lucky. Okay, so they think it's the resonance stone there. Could be. What is this about? To tell you the truth, we heard that Leon visited this place and came here to learn about something. In a way, the audition is a sideshow for us. Please take us to the place. Not a sideshow. You mean like a side quest or something. Oh, I see. In that case, I'll take you there later on. Thank you. I have some more things to do, so I'll get back to the reception. Let's meet up on the rocky shore later. I want to go back to the dock. Forte says, great. This time we should be able to find a resonance stone quickly. Right, says Una. McBain says, I was afraid Rish might have it already, but it was a needless fear after all. I'm sure things won't get complicated this time, says Una. You know they will. By the way, Grandpa, I have a little concern. Uncle Xiao used our name without permission, right? That's right, says Una. But we had no trouble at all at the reception desk. McBain says, anyway, it's only Xiao who knows our name and situation. No one will misuse our good name other than him. Let's find him and teach him a lesson while we wait for Elise to finish her work. Uncle Xiao, says Forte. Which room is he in? He can't be in the next room, or can he? I'm gonna go back to the dock and see if we missed anything there. Ah! McBain says, we must teach Xiao a lesson. Okay, we can't leave. Can't leave the... Okay, there's someone in there, but that's not Xiao. We can't leave the hotel. This is empty. Oh, there's a chest in that one. Orb of Ocean 105. What did I say? 25? 105. A marble with the image of Diva Wendy. It's 105, I said, right? Are they in numerical order? Yes. Okay. I thought I saw them out of order. I'm like, we can't have that. Oh, Xiao and Rachel. I see them. Oh, see her now. I thought you were the fake. Forte says, you're the musician who boarded the ferry before us. Well, it was just a mistake, says Una. Hmm, lucky you. Anyway, whether you're real or fake, you can't beat Cyrano to win. Three first-class performers have entered this audition. We have Sid Balthazar, the magician of piano, from the Cavaro International Theater, and Diva Wendy, the top-billing singing sensation, and Cyrano, the musical prodigy from Graysel. Forte says, have you heard his name in Graysel? I don't remember, says Una. It will be a three-way battle. Three-way battle. Okay. Right, so we went in here, right? We got the orb. And then in here is... nobody. And then in here is Xiao and Rachel.